challenge. Lady and I are ready to go. Thank you, coach, for offering another year of fun challenge. This is already getting out of control. Today, we're shooting a video to accompany vlog how to over prepare for Spinnables workout. So, stay tuned.
Lady is doing the weight room part of the living room. Here's a stability ball and various weights for ultra conditioning and still endurance.
First, I'm explaining what I wear. Right now I'm wearing a pretty cap, but this is just to show for the video. I usually have this off, tie my hair in the back with a rubber band, and as you can see, I have my cycling gloves on and a bib. The only time I wear a bib is inside. It's kind of tricky for a woman for bathroom. And I have my Garmin strap. I think this is a soft version and a good one. A lot of people are reporting some versions pretty bad. And I wear my mountain bike shoes with SPD on still. It's easy to walk around inside and outside. And wear CEP compression socks. This is running version. Comes in pretty pink and yellow and green. So this is pretty typical.
So I'm almost ready to start. Dog is setting up her trainer on this corner here to minimize the stinkiness to minimal. I usually have a candle on. Since this is a living room workout, I have my ceiling fan on already, as well as the air conditioning at 60 degrees. This is Texas, and I know some of you are gonna kill me. In Texas, nice weather, I'm still preferring to ride inside. So here is the over preparing part. I have two towels, one by the bike right here. So this is a dry towel, and I also have what I call ice bath. It's not like what runner will think, but I use this towel to put myself on me, dump water over the head and things like that. And since this is an over-prepared version, longer than 2 hour ride, I usually have a pitcher with ice like this and water here so I can keep, that's how I like to control temperature rather than having another fan blowing at me. And some of you may know I'm a very dehydrated person, so I have humongous amount of water. I would say this is safe for about 1.5 to 2 hours. It depends on all the day, but you know, if I don't use it, I'll put back in the fridge, so what the heck. And here I have clean bottle, and this is Accelerate. Accelerate is one of those protein, carbohydrate, 4-1 ratio sports drink, and this is a lemonade, the only flavor I care to drink. And I have a little Coke, actually Diet Coke, always do good. And then I have assortment of nutrition here. I like Good Chomps. This works for legs. And here is a good energy gel. I use this for energy. And I have a little Clif bar for food, the real food. But I don't seem to eat very much on real food. But it all depends, you know, which part of the day you are and you've been eating or you've not been eating. So I just have it prepared, over preparing. And the new addition this year is the salt stick. Lots of Spinnables friends recommended. This seems to work very well. Their manufacturer recommendation is one caplet every 30 minutes to an hour in very hard training. I do it anyway. Take one before and you watch the clock, and every 30 minutes, no matter what, seems to work well, very well for me. And the case here, I made a big deal out of asking in the Spinnables forum. I ended up having some kind of gel flask, some cheap brand, I guess. I haven't taken this to outside, but I prefer having round, not like the pill case from the pharmacy, because my husband doesn't let me carry anything, even plastic, that when it might break, it's gonna hurt me. So this is like a soft plastic, and besides, kind of soft. So I just open it, and it's rather big, but I think it's okay for taking outside too. So I have a mat. I think this is just a regular exercise mat, and kinetic road machine, and Cyclops have this sweat thing. I'm sure I'll put the proper name in the blog, and that comes with a remote holder. So this is my DVD remote, and this is the video remote, I mean the TV remote. And then this is the rubber band, I put it on the hair. Then I have this charge thing. Today I'm doing 27, so this power zones hopefully will change and make more sense. I have 9 speed, so I have the gear numbers, and also lifetime new leaf heart rate zone written right here. So, you know, before I pass out, I still know the numbers. So then, under the bike, I have the front wheel Cyclops block. I actually have 2 of these. So when it's a heel workout, it's one of those that's stackable. Of course, it's not gonna make a workout any tougher, but you know, just get the position, riding position feel to it. And then this is my Garmin. As you can see, I have cadence, distance. Oh, is it started? Then power, I got the power tab, maybe I should show again, and heart rate. I'm wearing heart rate monitor and the strap already, so it's showing the number. Well, this is the birthday present I got, power tab in the back. And then for the backup, I have the famous DigiFit. Everybody likes my pretty chart. And it's an iPad. I run on iPad. Let me just kind of show. Workout and indoor bike. And it will go like this. And it's not going to let me start because I don't have speed and cadence power. And it's, but you can see the heart rate will be red. My zone will be red. Power will be red. Cadence. And I think this is the time. If I use the lap, this is the lap time, and this is the speed, and the average RPM. So then I upload to New Leaf, which I don't have a trainer right now, but who knows, and Training Peaks Daily Mail to post to Facebook, and email myself and my husband from DigiFit. Then from Garmin, of course, as you know, people do, it will go up to Garmin Connect automatically, and everything is archived there. So I'm ready to start 27. Wish me luck. Good luck, everybody, with challenge. See you later. Bye.